Yes, hello friends, we'll be back again to this new video tutorial with the OSP Pro. In this video today, simply we're going to study Python. I know many guys have been asking me video for Python now. Members today officially began the Python video. And in this video, I remember making some videos back for Python, though they were a bit short and was mainly on a graphical user interface. Now today I'm going to be simply beginning complete Python programming video. If at all members you have not yet subscribed to my channel, please request you subscribe to my channel so that you can be you don't forget to get the notification whenever I happen to upload up a new video. And please also comment on my video whenever maybe you would like actually to get up a link so that you can always follow one another. Now these are the stuffs that we are going to be covering up in this video of ours of today. The first thing comes in first. The first stuffs we are going to be looking at up today is that we are going to learn at the moment, first of all, Python as a Python, and maybe I'll also go and talk about them. So we are going to first inquire about Python as Python. We are also going to see on the installation of Python. And we shall also see how interacting with the Python, how can interact with, then talk of the syntax, you know, the structure of Python, how does it tend to be like, then talk of the variables and maybe the data types that we shall also talk about in the Python. Then let us also, we shall also find later on on the basic operations of the Python, the basic operators that Python happen to have. Then we shall also look at one of the built-in functions. You get, so those are the main stuffs we shall also look at. Then conditional statements. Yes. Then we shall find up with the loops, and then user-defined functions also. Then we shall also go into now finally the classes, and maybe if I get time, we shall look at also objects. Now members, these are the first stuffs we are going to be looking to shortly and very fast, so that guys we find ourselves being on the safer side, so that we can be in position to run up one on us Python as a programming language, and also to be in the platform to make sure that guys we know Python. Now maybe I'll start by what's Python as Python. Now Python is an open source and it's a high level language. One thing I also have to let you know that Python was discovered in early 1980s, and it was mainly made, it is a high level language, and secondly for it is one known as interpreter language, whereby for it does not need a compiler to run a Python. Python for it interpreted a language. This means that every time a program is run, its interpreter runs through the code and translate it into what known as machine readable bytecode in a simple term. Now Python also has an ability to act in a format of one known as object-oriented programming language that allows users to manage and control data structure, or one known as also what known as it helps the objects to create and run the program in a simple term. So everything in Python is, in fact, the first class you have to always create up a class in whatever Python whatever stuff you'll be creating up in the Python. Now Python is not just like what on us Python is not like, in a simple term I will simply tell you, Python is not like C or what on us Java, where you have to first compile, then maybe the program happen to create for you the image of the object, and then later maybe happen to run. Now the stuff that Python are simple all is about what maybe happen to tell you. So that's mainly with the Python. So just like I've said, it's an interpreted programming language, and it's a high level language, and it's not like C or C++ or what known as Java, where we have to first compile and run for it. As long as you try to compute a statement, then it shall be running. Now mainly I'm using Windows, So since I'm using Windows, I'm just going to go straight forward and let's start showing you of up guys what you're going to be covering at the moment. We have other few stuffs that we shall going to be covering up with our Python program today. Just like I've said to you, right, for our first stuff in translation and down in installation, Python was mainly to download Python. I'll just go straight to downloading first of all before using. To download Python, you shall go to python.org organization, and this will take you straight to the downloading page where you shall be downloading the version of Python you want. Now this one is Python 3.6.2, the version there. You can also download one as the Python 2.7, which is also a very good and stable format of Python. So if you know you'd like to download, then I just request to go and just download that stuff around. Either using Windows or Linux, still will be in position up to downloading up your Python in your machine. Now after downloading, you'll discover that to Python, you'll get it as one known as a source like this. I already have the Python downloaded in my machine, and I'm just going to be explaining guys for you. So I already have your Python 2.7. Just go to where happened inform you, and also download Python 3.7, whatever you download. But mainly today in this video, I'm going to be using Python 2.7, though I'll show you all of the stuffs after downloading. Now to install Python, what you just have to do is just double click here on Python 2.7 if that's what happened download. And members will just be clicking next, next, next. If at all you're using Python 2.7, you'll just be clicking next, next, next. And if you also happen to come back and maybe happen to install Python 3.6.3, there's one thing that I want to let you know there. When you happen to double click this one on Python 3.6, there's something that happened to come there in that Python. One is that you are the one who have to let the Python add the Python to what known as the command line or the command prompt. This is what I mean. Okay, sorry that I already have that Python there, but actually I will show you what is necessary. But just like pick it from me that if you are to install that type of Python, you have to go to the part where they'll ask you that please you would like to add Python to the command prompt. Please, if you don't give it a tick, then it will not work out for you. Okay, if that's it, then that's great. So members, let us again now go straight to the Python. Now Python, you'll find that some of you guys who use Python Windows 7, or many of you, those of you guys who are using one known as who have happened to install Python 2.7.2, you'll discover that when you happen to run, when you try to click on the command prompt, your Python is not working. Now the reason is behind that you have not set up one known as the you didn't happen to set what known as your variable, your environment variables. And to do so, the thing I request to do is this. I just go to your machine where you happen to install Python. Mine is in C. Just go to Python there, double click there. And just inside here, just double click on the scripts. And now from there, just come and copy this very stuff. You happen to see from here, copy it, this very stuff. Right click, copy. After doing so, go to your computer, right click, go to the property, and then make sure you go to advanced system settings. Then go to environment variables, and then here, just go to new, click new. And then you just add there the path, click new. Then here up you can type on as the path of your Python. Then here down you paste the name of your Python, which is that. So when you click OK, the Python will be set for you in your path, and just you click OK, and then finish up with setting up your Python. If you are done with doing so, then I just expect you, members, as long as you come back down here, you just type on as Python. So when you type just Python, it should be in position to open up what known as something like that. Now this one I have is Python 3.6.2, but if also would like to run Python 2, I can always open up to write the version of Python in front. Then I happen to click enter. I'll just show you here if I would like to do so. Come back here, type quit, whereby if I happen to type one as Python 2, you as guys will find that Python 2 is not there. But just like I've said to you, you can also test by Python pip 2. That implies if I happen to click enter and then that stuff is there, it will just generate from all the Python 2 into machine, which I believe soon is going to start up processing up that stuff. So I request you guys, make sure you happen to find Python setup in the command prompt, because tomorrow if you'd like to use pip and then maybe Python is not set on the command prompt and the variable not taken right from the script, then you'll not be in a position at point T tomorrow to find that you guys, you can generate up these following stuffs into your Python and then maybe to install some packages. If you don't do so, then you'll not be in a position to install some of the packages that you may would like to use in your Python. Now that's it, my friends, and I'll just leave that alone at the moment. And then to go to the Python environment, in your command prompt you can just type Python. Now to start doing something, you can just say maybe 2. I think you can see as you type the stuff just goes on. And if you said 2 plus maybe 5, or if you say maybe 2 plus 5, definitely will be 7. So that's so far how you can set the Python in your command prompt. Members, let us use this time and then also go and try to get the Python, what known as the Python part of it, where we shall be using the graphical user interface. So you can also go to your start button in the keyboard. Now mine, if you happen to shake, I already have your Python here. So I have this Python GUI for Python 2.7 and I have this one also for Python 3.6. Now this is the Python 2.7, the one we are going to be using. So for you guys, you're just going to be typing here Python, and after doing so you'll be getting their Python 2.7 for you guys, but for me I already have mine here down. Okay, so members, let us utilize this time around to just try to see how can we now start up our tutorial, since down we are done with the what known as the installation. Now let me tell one thing before going further. Python is interacting with Python. Python is a dynamic and is a flexible that you can use in different ways. You can use it interactively when you simply want to test a code or statement on a line by line, or when you are exploiting features. You can also use Python as a script mode when you want to interpret an entire file of statement or application program. So Python has different ways how it's just like I happen to list for you, that the one which I happen to use command prompt, that's one. There's also this one way by you can just use the shell and then you open up Python, which is going to be popping up for us guys. So if maybe you have already have Python installed, I think just you can see I already have my stuff. I'm just going to minimize it so that you can fit the size of our shell. Now we have just like those stuffs, I happen to let you know that Python is friendly, that if you happen whatever it has you type as it prints out for you. That's all what I can simply say by Python being interactive. Now guys are using Linux or you're using on whatever stuff you're using, that then just follow me in the same way. So whenever or they use Python for command prompt here, I think you can see it also have that stuff, and also it has this stuff. Now that one is simply just to show that Python will be opening up the command prompt and maybe open up the shell where it shall be making up a Python program. Now if I told you using Windows, maybe when you're using Python 2.7 to start up your Python program to print hello world, you can always just type one on us hello world like that. So when you click enter, you'll discover that your Python will just print up. Then for my friends, any of you guys who are using Python 3 and above, I request you guys, if you're using Python 3 and above, don't type just hello world like this. It will not work out for you. For it, you need the one known as the brackets. So for you guys, you'll need one on us typing that, maybe hello, mean print. Then you type one on us hello world like that, whereby then it will print for you your message. So don't forget this too. With the Python 2.7, you can always use that, or Python 2, you always use with that bracket, you can always use, but with Python 3 and above, please, you have to make sure you have the bracket to handle up your statement. Now, if that's done, always, my friend, now, if at all the statement of yours didn't happen to go on well, if you happen just, I give assumption, you happen just have kind of a message like this, that implies, my friend, you have an error in your program. And there's also one known as the syntax errors that maybe tomorrow you happen to get in the program, give assumption. I happen to come and write T, and then I say maybe hello world, which is very correct. But you see, now that one at the end of the day is one known as the syntax error. But this is the error that what happened to give here, Python is not understanding at all. Those are the some of the stuffs that I'll happen to let you know. Then another thing that I have to let you know at the moment, if you want to execute Python to end up or to quit a Python, you'll be just typing one as quit like that. But when you click like that, Python will say that at least if you want to do so, you have to type one as quit with brackets. So to do so, you have to type one as quit then with brackets. That one, it will ask you, are you sure you want to stop, are you sure your program is still around, you want to kill it, so it will ask you that kind of command. Still the same as to the person who won't use that, you can also use exit. Still with exit, my friend, you'd also end up with one known as those type of brackets. So you also type one as exit like that. Still will ask you the same command. Now, my friends, if that's so far great, I think that's good for everyone who's going to be starting. So, and the next thing that maybe I have to let you know at the moment, having known all what so far we are trying to find out in our program today, there's other stuff that maybe I have to let you know. If you don't want to program your Python through this shell here, there's another new window which you can open up for the script mode. When you click here, you can go to new file, whereby here, this file you happen to see, you can type in your pieces of code at once, then you can give the Python the name, give assumption, we're going to just type hello world here, and then we'd like the Python to run for us. So if I would like to type something there, I'm just going to just come and type maybe print, and I say maybe hello world. Hello world, like that. So that's our statement. But if you'd like to do so, you can always have to save. So click on files, save as. I'm going to save in my desktop so that I can always go to it. Desktop, click then desktop. And I'm just going to say maybe YouTube. But remember, the save as type format is always one as Python files. So just click save. So when you click save, I think you'll be seeing a Python file for us here, which is now a Python. To do so, you can always just to run it, you can always press F5 or click the file, run, and then you click one known as run mode. So when you click run mode, you should be seeing here what known as hello world. I think, my friends, so far that's great. So if you know that you'd like to use Python in that format, that's also how we happen to use Python in that way. So that's how they use the script shell or the shell, which is got from this stuff here. We always click on file, then you click open. So members, that's how I will simply say at the moment. So let me close that, I don't need it at the moment. Now let us also come back down in our program and try to find out some few and other stuffs within the program. We have also other stuffs that I have to let you know if maybe you would like to come up with up your program, Python program. Now Python have those kind of white lines that can always be written or be left by the program. It Python tends to ignore it. So white lines or these blank lines, they are ignored by Python. So if you write your program, give assumption A is equal to having 4, you can always press as many enters, but next time when you press A, it will recall that A was at point T, it was 4. That implies every time we'll be giving A, Python will be knowing it that A is equal to 4. So in a simple term, that's what I will simply say there. Then maybe another thing that I have to let know at the moment is now comment, because that's where I'm going to be next to. Comments. So in a simple term, what are comments? And the comments just refers to the what known as the codes written by the programmer, and they are hidden from the compiler, or they're hidden from the machine during the time of processing the codes, or the interpreter, it will bypass those codes without the processor seeing. In Python, we have some types of comments. Though I may list not very many, I may just list a few. We have this one we call the hash. This is one known as singular in comment. So this is a comment. So the interpreter will not see it. So we see when you click enter, it has no problem. But if you happen to press another stuffs, like maybe this forward slash, which used to be a comment in C or in what known as PHP, you'll discover when I click here, it is a syntax error that implies it is not a comment. So this is a comment in the Python. How about if someone happened to give two forward slash, but in between puts two multiplication sign? Does Python need to know that this is a comment or what? Those are not comment. So the main comment I'll give you, my friend, in Python is this hash. And another thing that I have to let know also in Python that maybe you guys have to learn is that in Python we have also the syntax. So the syntax simply refers to the rules governing what known as the program, or how Python program is laid out. Now, first of all, just like I've said to you, Python, you can write it in the format you want. We have this forward slash, and whatever we have to have printers inside here becomes the printout statement. So the print enables us to print out the statement in Python. Now another thing that maybe have to let you know at the moment is that we have some key preserved words in Python, like and. We also have break. We have continue. We also have one as else. We have define. We have delete. We have assert. We also have one as class. Just want to list some and few. Now these are the main. I'll simply just take that at the moment, but there are very many. There is even one as global. There's one was global. There are very many of them. There's width, you get. Now those stuffs, parts like that, they are preserved keywords in Python that for them we shall be using them when we are defining of our variables, or when later on we are trying to come up with a program and would like to. They are, in a simple term, I'll simply say Python keywords are reserved words in Python that should not be used in as variables. So constants, functions on them, or identify in your code. So take note of this, because only time if you happen to use them in your program, otherwise you'll get an error. That's what I'll simply happen to let you know at the moment. So we also have the identifiers, which is a name given to a function or a class, a variable, mode, or any other objects that will be using your Python program. So we have them, and I'll also show you how to maybe happen to print them in your program. Give assumption, if you want to define a variable, you can always define a variable like this. Give assumption, you can say A is equal to having maybe 4. So whereby next time whenever you have to write A, it will always know that's 4. Or you can also define your variable as A_ is equal to 5. That implies every time you happen to write A_, it will just know that that's equal to 5. How about if you happen to write A_A, that one applies it to another different variable. Because if you happen to write maybe A_ is equal to 3, it will also know that's another different variable. That implies you can, whenever time you happen to do that, it will be another variable. In a simple term, A_ is equal to 5 is totally different term, as A is totally different from underscore A. In other words, it's two different statements. So there are two different identifiers of variables. Then also addition to that, we also have other key terms that may be in Python. We don't use them, and they're also preserved. And that those are special characters that are not allowed within identifiers. So one of them, we have what must the hash, the at. We have the percent, and it may be also simply that this one here. We have also have the dollar sign. So those ones are mainly the Python key terms that we don't use whenever we happen to make up a Python program. So in a simple term, that's what I'll happen to let you know, my friends, within this period of time, as maybe I'm done with a simple explanation. So we just have the variables, just like I've said to you, you can define them the way you want. So here there are some few stuff that maybe I have to let you know at the moment. One, if you say maybe you can define a variable in any way you want, maybe x equals to 3, and then maybe y is equal to a 5. So if you want to find z, you can only say that maybe z is equal to having z is same as having y plus x. So next time when you call z, when you happen to call z in the program, you'll get to know that z is 8. So those are the simple ways how to define your variable in Python. So that's it, my friend. And you can also play around with the variable, that variable. You can add something to the variable, which definitely can give you what known as a 15. Now we also have one known as data type. So Python handles several data types to facilitate the needs of programmers and application developers for workable data. Now this includes the strings, numbers, booleans, list, date, and what known as time. Whereby the strings deals with the letters, numbers, then numbers deals like those integers, and then booleans are deals for those with known as true or false, then list, they are in the form of what known as arrays, then date, that's time, and time. So we have very many of them. Give assumption, let me start with the strings. So give assumption, if I happen to say maybe this is string 1, is equal to, now whenever we have a string, can use a single or double quote. Let me just use string double, and I say maybe I'm David and I love programming, if that's it. So you can end in Python with the same colon, or you may ignore same colon. Maybe I've happened to forget to tell you that. So when I happen to click enter, next time when I happen to write this string 1, you'll discover that it will print for me that statement. You get? So in Python, that's what I have to let you know at the moment. So next time when you happen to tell the program to print for you that stuff, or give assumption, add another string, maybe string 2 is equal to, and in maybe if I'm in Uganda, just say that. In Uganda, let me just try to explain for you something here. Now, if you don't want to just come here and type on a string 1 or string 2, you can also just come until a Python print for me the string's name. You give a string name, if string 1 or string 2. So it will also do for you the same thing, print for you the same statement of your program. So that's also what I have to let you know at the moment, whenever you are playing up with your Python program. Now, give assumption, you can also hold up text. Give assumption, have your text somewhere you happen to save in the desktop or anywhere in the program, and let maybe Python to print out for you. You can also do the same thing. Python can also do for you the same thing, whereby it can happen now maybe to print for you a statement depending on what you want. Now, string, let me just use this minute now again, my best, to take you into what is a list. Or list. Now, this one here, list, like I've said, it behaves in the same way like one known as arrays, if you guys happen to handle arrays some time back. Like, give assumption, if I say maybe, let me just say maybe names, or student, underscore name to be my next variable here, or name is equal to having what known as give assumption. I'm just going to say maybe David. Get that's a student name. So next time I can simply use one as if you just come and type student name like that, you'll discover that at the end of the day it will produce for you that name. How about if I would like only the letter from the name to be printed out? I'll use array. Now in Python I'll use one known as list. So I need to call up list to be part of this program. I'll simply type the variable name, which is called student. Underscore name, then specify which letter would you like to pick from the program. Now remember, from our arrays or in PC on our whatever program language you're from, apart from Python, this one is these zeros, this is one, this two, this three, and this four. The same applies to list. If I would like to pick this letter A, meaning letter D from here, the first letter here, which is D, to be printed out for me, I'll say zero. That implies when I click enter, it will pick for me D. That implies in the same way, if I happen to say I would like Python to print for me the first letter and with maybe the second letter, which is 1. If I happen to click enter, sorry, just try to pick for you this around here. If I happen to come in here before that and I try to say I want the second letter, it is that. You'll find at the end of the day the Python will try to print for you the letter in the program. Now if you would like to pick the last character in your program, then what you have to do, you have to come back here and specify the first of all the length of your program, which is the length in the character. And then here again you'll specify what is the name of the variable you happen to declare in the program, which is that. And then whereby this is going to be a bracket like that, it's a bracket, but then it is minus one whenever you want to access what is the last character, which is D. I give assumption I just happen to change this variable name of that person to one known as OSP, whereby if I happen to come back here and I would like to access the last person from the program, then you will just get now it is going to be P, which is that, to for you to understand how to access the last character in the program. So you can go on and try to pick whatever person you like to know from the program. Now Python also have what on us what you guys you can term at one on us call concatenating a string, or what on us joining up different strings with within concatenating a string. What you guys know as like joining up different strings together in Python. I give assumption if I say maybe my name is David, and then maybe I would like to join these two stuffs. I give assumption really have one variable called names, and the names maybe is equal to having maybe a David, and then maybe I just going to say F name is going to maybe OSP. So if I would like to join those two stuffs, it's right, it's upon you. You can always come and say names. Then you say plus OSP, where by the end of the day, I said names plus OSP, or OSP was not defined, sorry for that. I said here maybe you can simply say what as a names plus F name. So at the end of the day, look at that. So to differentiate that between the two statements, you can always come up with what known as a single kind of bracket here, open up there, then you join up the statement with that. So when you click enter, you'll get up the same string concatenated. So you can also use a string for repeating up some statement within the program. I gave assumption. We'd like now to print up some person. The print, you happen to define some variable. Give assumption. I'm going to say names is equal to maybe having one as OSP. So if you'd like to print OSP, depending on the number of times you'd like to print out the statement, what you can always do up in Python is you are specifying the variable name. Like give assumption there, the variable name is names, and that variable name will be equal to what known as the quote, like that. The initial the quote, you can write what known as the asterisk, then you use that kind of the multiplication sign, then you can also specify with that. Or in a simple term, if you don't want that, you can just come down here. Since you already have the variable name, what you can just do, type s and then give what known as the number of times you would like, if I say 5. So at the end of the day, it will print OSP 5 times. This is the first time, this is the second time, this is the third time, the fourth time, and the fifth time. So that's in a simple way how, guys, you can always come up with what you would like to know. And another thing, give assumption still, when you say OSP is equal to my name is equal to OSP, that's it. So if you'd like to know the number of the size of the strings, you can simply just come and say ln like that, and then you can come on also and type on as names in the program. At the end of the day, it'll tell you the number of the size is 3, because they are 3 letters. And also, there's this one known as slicing string. So you can create substrings with the slicing notation. You can do this by placing two indices or separated by a column. I give assumption if you the same their names of ours. If I come down in the program here and I happen to say maybe names, and then maybe I happen to say names, that's what we have, but I would like to break that stuff within the program. I can simply specify the number of columns I would like to use. So if I happen to come back, then I type in, you'll discover that this one is trying to say in the simple term that don't print for me this O, instead print for me number one, because this in a simple term, they're like arrays or one known as list. The same applies if I would like now to talk about the first person. If I want to talk about the first pass, first letter, I'll just type kinda that, or with full column that, whereby this will produce from the complete statement. And maybe if I would like now to generate everything there, I'll just type now kinda that, so that I can get the first within the program. Now that's it, my friends. If maybe that's great with you, then that's good. So you can also turn your small letters into uppercase in the Python, just in this format. Just like now we have names is equal to our OSP, which we have so far at the moment. I'm just using that for simple demonstration, my friends, so that you can be in the same base and code faster. So already have names is equal to having OSP. Or you can even say always people, whatever you'd like to do. So if you want to turn it to capital letters, what you have to do, you'll just type one as a print, then you open up and type what's the name of the variable, which is names, then dot one on as a lower, if that's already in a lower case, but would like to turn it in upper case, which is that. That's it. So when you happen to click here, I think you can see now it's capital letters. My friend, the same applies if you have stuffs in small letters, give assumption and names, and I capitalize it, and I say maybe Nya Bonyo Faith, something like that. If that's the name of the person, just copy the same stuffs, and I happen to paste it there, and I maybe happen to put there maybe equal sign. So that's it. So if I want to make these same things in small letters, I will simply say print, then I give the variable name, which is going to be names, like that. Then use one as uppercase letter now, upper like that. So at the end of the day, it will discover that what was, sorry, this is small capital letters. We can also print it in small letters by giving ordinals names dot lower, like that. So at the end of the day, we shall get the person's capital letters to a small letter in the program. So we can also find those with non-strings by then to turn them into strings and then you print them together. Give assumption, if you try to cross-check in pi, we have one known as pi, and program knows that pi is equal to 3.14, no, or something like that. Pi is equal to have known as 3.14, something like that. So every time when I happen to say pi, pi is null. But we can turn this pi into a string by we just typing known as this one here. We would like to turn this pi into a string, whereby every time, now this is turned to a string from this, which is a number, into a string. You get, so that we can even print it together. Give assumption, if I happen to say maybe print maybe the value for pi is now there you're going to join the two statements. By have to join, you'll just be joining with what knows this, so that you happen to get no error whenever you happen to type the program. So you discover that now this is a string, is no longer a single letter. Now friends, that's how you can do it. Now there's other stuff that you can simply say. You can also use there's this one as finding complex numbers. You can also just show you a little bit of complex number. You give assumption, if you have a, as you could have 3 plus maybe 5j, that's what you have. You can also get another one, b is equal to having maybe 52 minus or plus 6. Maybe still if it is j, then it's fine. So if you would like the program to print for you out the output, you will discover that we'll just type one on us. You just need to get now maybe the file which is going to be print to print for us. Maybe if maybe that's it, just type also maybe c. We also have maybe c which is going to having maybe a, maybe plus or minus, just a plus b to space save time. So when I happen to say now print c, you'll discover that c is also going to be additional to that. So that's how you can also use what knows as the complex number. Then there's also conversion of number of type, like if assumption to know the type of those numbers. If I just happen to say maybe give assumption, if I just happen to say maybe float for us c, you'll discover this sorry for that. But in a simple term, let me just try to see how we can get some number. If I say maybe float 12, in a simple term, that one will give us number in a decimal place, a value. Get. And maybe if I also have maybe to happen to say int 12, you will discover that there it will be an integer. Get. And if you also happen to use complex. If you happen to say complex, maybe at 12, if that's at the point, you'll discover that it will also provide for you even with the values that maybe happen to be there in the program. Now, there's another thing that I have to let know within this period of time is date and time. How can you play around with them? So you can simply say from date, time, import one on us. You can simply say from date time, import one on us date time. Date time, like that. So this one simply is going to enable us to know date and time now. So if I can simply say date time now at the moment, that one will generate first the time and the date and everything if it is time right now, and will compute it down for us. So you can also compute the stuff bending on the years. So give assumption from still import time, you can also import one as the command that will enable you to format or whenever get the
the format you like of what you want. If that format you don't want, you can also still format it. So you simply say from time, maybe import whatNOT as a string, whereby string is tar for time. You convert them together. Just cross check FT MT like that. Import that for our program. So if I try to cross check, if I say the same thing again, that's what I'm trying to pick around time. What do I want? If maybe I would like to give the stuff in my way or on my binary the way I would like it to be, I'll simply say maybe this is going to be yes, and then percent is going to enable us to get the format we would like to get in the program, which is going to be percent d also to many days. And then percent h for our full column, percent m for mint, full column, percent s for seconds. So if you cross check here on the program, you shall be getting that's it. So if you try to cross check again, that's what so far we have. There's also one as boolean, and this is how boolean tends to behave. So comparison in Python can only generate one of two possible responses for true or either false. So boolean behaves in that way. So give assumption if it's a bool underscore this boolean one is equal to maybe having a maybe for, and is also equal to maybe one on us maybe two times four. That's what you get for that boolean. And maybe you say for boolean underscore two, we have the values which is equal to maybe 12, and maybe it is for less than maybe two times that, you get. So that's what we have. So if you'd like the program now to print for you out the boolean, so if I say print now maybe boolean underscore one, you'll discover that now it's going to be false because it is for sure it's not true. You get that same applies to boolean at this, which is also going to be if you try to say maybe to boolean to bool underscore two, which you also would like to print out. So if you happen to come back here and say for bool underscore two, you'll discover that now that one is going to generate for it true. So members, that's how you can simply also use boolean for your simple conversion, or for trying to do stuff you would like to maybe to generate in your program. Now give assumption, let me take you something else. If I try to happen now, let me just also show you illustrating about list now form. Let us go to list. Now with list, I give assumption have the class, and I say maybe I'm going to use array kinda, and I say maybe this car is red in color, and maybe the other one is maybe orange. I also have another car, maybe the car is green in color. Let me just take that view for study purpose. If I happen to click enter, that's what we have. Now if I would like to pick someone, the cars in them, in whatever, remember you said cars red blah blah. So if you just come here down and just say maybe print cars like this, you're going to see what will happen. If I just say print cars, it will print from the same arrays. But if I would like to pick a particular car inside the program, I'll simply say print, then here I come and say car, and then maybe if I say cars, I have to specify which array. Remember, if you say zero, that implies that car is red. And the same applies if you just happen to come back again in the program and say maybe print cars, then maybe you happen to say the car is two. That implies a simple okay one at the moment, you'll discover that that car is orange. Okay, so that's how we pick information in arrays. Now still, Python also have one known as the basic operators that we can simply talk about this addition, assignment, logical, and what known as others, B2C membership, blah blah, those are types of operators. Now with the addition, is this the same thing that you guys have been doing around with you, whereby what happens, semi bit is that plus that, you simply get the answer, which is that is it. The subtraction is still the same thing, or division is the same thing. Let me just take it to the exponent. If you'd like to give an exponent, the value, give us something, you want to say that one exponent 3, which is maybe 8, that's how you give it. If it is that exponent 2, which approximate will give you 25, that's how you give the exponent. Then with the modulus of a number, if you'd like now to give the modulus of any given number of yours, to do so, you'll just give maybe if it is 12 modulus. So with the modulus, you give percent of any number, which is going to be 0 because that number divided by that will give you that. Example, if again say modulus of that modulus 8 will give you approximately 4 because the remainder is going to be 4. Now we also have other stuffs there. Now floating division, so if you would like to float division like 17, float it by 5, you will simply get 3. And if I tell you, if I say 12, I float by 5 still, it is going to be 2. So you are floating up a division of your program. So that's how I simply going to say what we so far have within our program at the moment. Now let us also look into what NAS. Just also look right now. Now members at the moment, I'll just take you into what NAS, the logic operators. Now with the logic operators, here we believe A then O. We have two types of operators here in the logic operators. We have one NAS for O, or what NAS AND. There's a logical O and logical AND. So give assumption, I have some values here. Some values here of mine, yeah. If this is maybe 4 times, maybe that you get maybe if I say that's it, and maybe also have values 2, maybe is less than just try to make this very clear. If I get 4, is greater than 5, and maybe I happen to say maybe 5 3 is greater than 2 1. If it is 2, it will give us here 2 for those kind of operation. Otherwise, if it is false, now how does the logical AND behave, or many logical operators tend to behave? With the logical AND, if one is not correct, then all the thing is wrong. But if the logical OR, as long as one condition is correct, then the rest is correct. Give assumption still here. If I happen to say maybe it is 4 greater than 3, which is true for that case. And how about if I happen to say that 3 is greater than 1? That one is verified to be true, otherwise it will give you true. Now with the logical OR behaves in this way. If one part of the program is true, then everything is going to be true. You don't care about which other part. As long as one of the program is true, then it's true. So give assumption here, if I happen to say maybe for 3, but for this one for sure it's less than 1, whereby it's not correct. So this part is true, but this part is wrong. So at the end of the day, when I compute, it will be okay, use the AND. I didn't use O, just use O here, so that you guys can get to know what I'm trying to talk about. Just use your O, and then we happen to compute that, whereby here, if I happen now to change that one to O, and happen to compute, you'll discover that now, is A greater than 5, this is wrong, and how about A, this is. So let me just try to change that a little bit again. Here for A is less than one part to be correct and the other part to be wrong. For A is less than that, so whereby now there's going to be true. That's what simply I'll happen to say now at the moment. Now there's just other type of operators, but now let me just leave that, and then you guys, you can always go and find out now. Now let me just go to my other thing which happened to say among the list of the programs that we said we are to cover. Let me just go straight to what known as built-in functions, and then I happen to show you that very fast if possible. So the function provides the features and subtract to the program language. So Python has what known as a useful in-built-in function to make programming easier or faster and more powerful. So we have some function like input function. Let me just show one. I give assumption. If I happen to say maybe name, And we say maybe the name is equal to one less input. We expect the user to enter in the input, maybe my what is your name. Now this one becomes what known as the input or the inbuilt function. So if you happen to cross check, that's it. So it'll ask you what's your name. So here I happen to put my name is maybe David, if that's my name. So if you click enter still, what is your name? Oh, sorry, at the moment. So if you'd like that one to print for us and try to concatenate for us our name, I'll just want to come back again still here and I just try to explain to you these pieces of code before that I happened to make a mistake when I was clicking enter. So that's what we have there within the program. But if I happen to come and I say print for us, maybe maybe to try to pick the name, which is that line 0. Okay, sorry for that. So if I happen to say maybe my name is, so if I happen to say that's my name, now I'll join with the variable I happen to put, which is name. So if I happen to do so, I'll just come back in here and then I happen to click enter. Okay, shake this again, just try to do something. X, or just a name is equal to input. Now they'll expect us to enter some input, your name is, may have that value for us, of that's what we have there, my name is. So if you click enter, your name is, let me just simply say maybe OSP. Don't know why this version of my pair is not giving me out yet. I happen to say here my name is, I think there has to be some little problem, but then it would actually definitely give me out the output. I have to first cross check what's wrong with my program, otherwise to do generate for me the output. That's what I'll simply say I have at the moment. So members, guys, don't forget to subscribe to my channel for other more extra videos that will be coming up, for mainly one known as the conditional statement loops, user-defined functions and classes. That's where now next time we shall be finding ourselves in to proceed with other more programming videos. So guys, thanks for watching. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you all.